January 11th, 2016, scheduled meeting at Robertson School for Malcolm Porter. Please silence all cell phones and electronic devices and join me in the silence. Thank you. Please stand.
Our pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, you may be seated. Ladies and gentlemen of the board, this evening we have Joe Burns Elementary School, and we're going to ask for these young men and women to say their name and what grade they're at. And Ms. Doris made a good point. This is a very momentous occasion because this is the first group to lead the pledge in our new district office. So one of these staff may be a trivia question, you never know. So we're going to ask that they give their name and what grade they're in, and then we'll turn around and do it again.
My name is Marjorie.
All right, and now for the other side of the room, if you all will turn around, and we're going to start on this end again.
My name is Dawson Gentry, I'm in fifth grade.
My name is Michael Bradley, and I'm in fifth grade.
My name is Kyle Bergen, I'm in fifth grade.
My name is Kendall.
Ruth Keller, I'm in kindergarten.
My name is Kilton Holmes, and I'm in third grade.
My name is Kier, I'm in second grade.
Thank you very much. We also have both Ms. Moore and Ms. Wilson, principal and assistant principal from Joe Burns Elementary with this group. You all want to add anything?
These are majority teachers' kids, and then we have our PTO president and her two sons here, so we appreciate them coming out tonight.
And this is a good representative. All right, we have certificates for you that we're going to give you in the hallway, okay? Ms. Doris, if you'll lead us.
Good job, thank you.
Students and their achievement must be the focus of our every meeting, our every plan, and our every decision. The mission and vision statements of the Robertson County School System are the expressions of what we believe and what we expect. We believe our mission is to ensure that each student is prepared to succeed in life. Our vision is that Robertson County Schools will enable all students to reach and exceed high academic and career standards while empowering them to succeed in a technologically advanced and culturally diverse society.
We have before you tonight an agenda and consent items on there. What is your pleasure?
Motion to approve. Second.
Motion's made by Mr. White and seconded by Mr. Crockett. Any questions or discussion? All those in favor make it known by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion passes. Okay, we'll move on to recognition of student, teacher, and school achievements.
Just me, is nobody else more? Aye. We're gonna do them one at a time, but I feel we could do them both because it's just like family. There's not one out there, I don't believe, that hadn't seen a softball game or a football game in Greengrass. So I'm glad to have all of you here. Judy Head, if you would please come forward. And I'm gonna clap for y'all. All right, Judy, this is a certificate of appreciation. Coach Julie Head, in recognition of 30 years of service as an exemplary coach and role model for students in Robertson County, the director of schools and the board of education, extend our appreciation for your outstanding coaching career. And I just wanted to ask a couple of things before I give that to you. Yeah, you have to.
You didn't correct me.
I know. Tell me how many of you have. See, that Kirk can feed off this because he knows it's coming.
He's got their feeders yeah. Right now.
How many wins do you have?
In softball, I think I had 576.
That's a bunch of wins. And that's one state championship, and you was there how many times?
We were there 5 times.
5 times in all, one once.
One once, runners up once.
And then you coached basketball for many years?
Coached basketball 13 years.
So, did you coach anything else?
I coached volleyball before Mitzi.
Thanks for showing up.
Mitzi showed up and showed me how it really was supposed to be done. So, I coached volleyball my first few years there and then moved on to other things.
Well, I can tell you from the bottom of my heart is having a child that has come through. And dealing with your daughter is I helped coach her and being with Captain Willie on our trips all over Eastern United States playing softball. It has been nothing but a pleasure, and you've done a wonderful job with the kids that you've dealt with. And I'm just, that's so nice.
Thank you.
If good, you can come Kirk Williams to come forward, please. Dr. Osborne, I'm going to get you in just a second, okay? So you just come back. Pack up. And y'all don't know this, but this is my brother. And we've been through a lot together. And I love him, just like a brother. And Kirk, this is for the board. It says, in recognition of 33 years of service as an exemplary coach and role model for the students in Austin County, the director of schools and the board of education, I appreciate you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And I'm going to ask you. I know, you know how many you had at Greenbrier, how many wins, and we talked about.
Well, Julie had 500 and what? I had just one more.
Good answer. And you also had a, you can see, Coach Williams was at Springfield as well. And won state championship at Springfield with Randy Thomas and that crew.
That's right.
And Coach, you as well. And our daughters have traveled together playing softball, but you've coached my son and treated him like your son. And you are a brother to me, just like you are to a whole lot of people out there. And I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Would you step over here for a minute? She don't know what I'm doing. Coach Middleton. How many wins have you had? No, I'm sorry. If you would, please introduce our new football coach.
Chair Ted Greenbrier. And also, if you have any words about Julia or Kirk, that's very important.
Of course she does that. If you don't mind, just say that you have family with you.
Yes, she does.
If you have your family stand, please be ready.
There we go.
I vote, your family please stand.
Ladies and gentlemen, I can't emphasize enough how much having wonderful coaches who are role models. Coach Ted.
It's on. She just needs to sit up.
Coach Ted and Coach Williams are just impeccable role models for our students. They are a joy to work with. They're leaders, and what they have done for the communities, we'll never know. It will last long after I'll be there. So just the impact that they have made, the coaching aspect is just so important. So thank you for all that you've done, because they have lent so much to us. And at this time, I'd like to introduce John Elmore.
You said John.
Coach John Elmore has been in our county for 25 years, and I am very excited about him taking the reins as our new head football coach. I'm looking forward to this fall. He's already taken over, so very excited about what's coming up. And he is also a fantastic role model in person for our students.
Thank you.
Space that is not currently in use, so I will send an email and let you know where that's going to be. But it will be open to the community, and I will have teachers and students discussing the topic of assessment and the excessive testing that's occurring in the state of Tennessee right now. The other date that I wanted you to go ahead and be able to get on your calendars is May 3rd. That is the RCEA retirement banquet. And you'll be getting an invitation later, but I wanted you to go ahead and get that on your calendar. We usually do that at 6. So on May 3rd. I also hope that you guys will approve our calendar. The RCEA and the board committee met and discussed that and spent a lot of time working on that calendar. Ms. Mason, I know, is going to present that later. So I hope you all will take that into consideration. And finally, I know they've already gone, but Coach Head and Coach Williams were both my high school teachers. So they really inspired a lot of students over the years. They're two of the teachers that I know when we have our class reunions, their names always come up as people who inspired us and made a lot of us want to go into the education profession. So I just want to thank them for all their work in the community.
Thank you. Okay, we'll move on to our expense comparison report. No, excuse me, personnel report.
Madam Chairman, members of the board, you have in your binder your report for this month. The certified personnel, we had 0 leave of absences submitted. We had 3 retirements and 8 resignations, 1 transfer, and 13 new hires. On the classified support side of the house, we had a total of 4 leave of absences, had 1 retirement, 5 resignations, 7 transfers, and 29 new hires for a total of 46 personnel actions on the classified side. That concludes my report. Subject to your questions.
Any questions? And then we'll move on to the expense comparison.
The expense comparison report is also included in your packet. We, at this time last year, we were at 33.97% of revenues received. Right now, we are at 33.65% of revenues received. Our expenditures, we are at 36.95% of the budget. And this time, last year, this time, this year, same time, we are 35.91% of our budget. We are under what we were spending as percentages. Property tax, we have, this time last year, we had 8.72% of property tax paid. As of the end of November 30th, we had 10.81% of property tax paid. Sales tax, last year we had 33.71%. This year we are at 34.15%. And it's up about $300,000 this year. Expenditures, electricity last year was at 43.19% of our budget at the end of November. This year we are at 44.58%. Diesel fuel last year was at 38.37%. This year we are at 25.42%. Quite a significant drop there. Gasoline, this time last year, we were 57.53% of our budget expended. This year, we're 28.87% expended. Insurance, 39.48% last year versus 38.83% this year. Subject to your questions, that completes the comparison, the expenditures and revenues comparison.
Any questions? We'll move on to approval for Matlock Clements to conduct fiscal year 16 student activity fund audit.
Madam Chairman, members of the board, I would like to recommend that we re-employ Matlock Clements to do our in-school audits for the upcoming, for this year that we're in, 2016. This company is, we've used for quite some time. The cost would be $17,134.
Motion to approve, please.
Is there a second?
Second.
Second, Mr. White. Now, any questions or discussion?
You're also approving, I don't know whether I said this or not, the in-school, inter-school funds, activity funds, and the food service.
Those in favor, make it known by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion passes. Approval of 2016-2017 system calendar.
Thank you. Members of the board, tonight I am bringing you a draft calendar for the 16-17 school year. Work went in by the calendar committee that was made up of Nikki Fields, Donna Darris, Becky Elmore, all of you are here tonight, as well as Springfield High Assistant Principal Jeff Haynes, Courtney Meek, an elementary teacher in our district, and Kelly Armstrong, the principal. The draft calendar that you have before you is very typical to those in the past years, with a couple of exceptions. Start and end times are very similar, as well as the typical holidays, a fall break and a spring break. We do have some added PD days built into the calendar. These are substituting for the previous curriculum planning days, and we have changed our early release to be 2 hours instead of a half day, and a couple more of those have been built in. If you have any questions, please let me know, and we ask for your approval.
Thank you very much. The 2016-2017 school calendar, as presented.
Second.
Motion on Mr. Prophet, a second on Mr. Payne. Any discussion or questions? All those in favor, make it known by saying aye. next item is approval of bid packet for ADA compliance plans to school athletic facilities.
Madam Chairman, members of the board, we have with us this evening Mr. Joe Haddock from Civil Site Engineering, who, his company, the company that was contracted to develop engineering plans to make three of our schools ADA compliant. And when I say schools, I school athletic venues, I should say. We identified East Robertson High School, Springfield High School athletic venues, and Coopertown Middle School venues that did not meet ADA requirements. And that was brought to our attention by citizens here in Robertson County. The board, I think sometime last fall, employed Civil Site to develop those plan specifications. And the last board work session, you had an overview given by Mr. Jim Harrison. Tonight, Mr. Joe Haddock is here to answer any questions you might have, but I would ask that you approve these plans and specifications so that we can put them out for bid. So with that, you want to go ahead and call before you get a motion on the floor. Go ahead and get a motion to approve.
Motion to approve. Second.
Motion by Mr. White and second by Mr. Payne.
Please address your questions to Mr. Joe Haddock.
Good evening. The plan is substantially the same as Mr. Harrison presented at the work session last month. Basically adding sidewalks, trying to utilize as much of the existing infrastructure, stone that's there, yeah, as part of the pavement section, either asphalt or concrete, depending on the area. Also adding at least two handicapped parking spaces at each sports field at each of the schools.
I was not at the work session, okay. So I apologize. Can you just give me a big, broad brush overview of what we're doing in each facility?
Coopertown, two handicap spaces between the baseball and football fields. There'll be a 20-foot ramp coming from the Circle Drive down to those fields, and then a 10-foot wide asphalt trail to each of the fields, kind of splitting off. Up at the football field, I'm going to pave all around the concession stand and around one side of the field to the bleacher pad. At Springfield High School, addition of two handicap spaces at the softball field, a ramp up to the field, and a 20-foot wide concrete path around from dugout to dugout, basically the bleacher pad in the seating area. Baseball field, two handicap spaces up down the first baseline, and then an 8-foot wide path or concrete path down around the field to the dugout on the third base side. East Robertson, multiple handicap spaces near the existing ticket booth at the football field. And then a ramp from the ticket booth down to the bleachers at the football field. And then an asphalt trail around to the visitor side of the football field, which will also connect to the softball field and then new pavement directly around the dugouts at the softball. Baseball field, concrete pavement from dugout to dugout, and then a ramp from the baseball field level down to the concession restroom building.
So are you saying all the access to the baseball field will still come in through this ticket area, or you still don't have access up there by the pipers?
We're utilizing the pipers. It will be, my understanding, that will still be the main access to the baseball field. We're just tying right to the end.
One thing I wanted to add to your timeline, also at last month's meeting, and Jerry wanted you to know if you didn't see it, we went ahead and asked for them to go ahead and do all the schools that have outside facilities.
And I have made that request, okay. And they are in the process of surveying those sites to make sure that they come back with some plans for those. The switchback, is that a switchback ramp that you got going in there at East Robertson?
Yes, sir.
That football field, it's a It's a switchback, six A down to the field. That's a pretty steep bank.
It is.
It's about a lot of grade.
Yes.
But then the over where the pavers are, I think you're just taking off there and doing a one.
Yeah, we'll flush right to the end. We're not going to touch those.
We're not going to destroy those pavers. I think the names on the truck.
Yeah, that's right.
But you still, you'll leave the existing for non-handicap.
Yes. Yeah, the new scissor ramp at the football field is just right at the next to the stairs.
Next to the stairs.
Yes.
In your estimation, how long will it take us to get this installed once the bid is let? How long will it take a contract to do these three sides?
Weather dependent, 2 to 3 months. Again, weather this time of year, kind of has a mercy of Mother Nature.
We have baseball season starting in February.
We have, yes, we have a game.
Right. I was just saying, we're going to have construction going on during the ball season.
The plan is to, providing y'all approve this, is to take it to bid, you get a price, burn price, just what it's going to cost. Once that's done, next board meeting, February the 1st, we hope to have those, we will not hope, we plan to have those prices for your consideration for you to accept or reject, and then we can let a bid after your approval. The other part of this is we're going to do funding. We've got some money in our fund balance that we could use, but we may want to ask the county commission for additional funding for this as well.
That's right. With your approval tonight, we'll start tomorrow contacting the contractors, advertising the paper. Right now, we're scheduled to open bids on the 26th, so that'll give us time to evaluate and get a recommendation for you.
And Mr. Converse, for your information on the last meeting, there was an estimate, I believe, of perhaps about 108,000.
It was between 90 and 108, 110,000.
About $108,000 for this free process.
Yeah, it's something we got to do.
Yeah, we have to do it. There's no.
Springfield had the widest variation.
Yeah.
But we didn't have.
Okay. Yeah, what we got to do, we got to do.
And going back to your question about scheduling the baseball softball start, we can put in our bid packet, we'll add, which one of these they need to focus on first. Let's see if the baseball softball field's done now. Get those first, maybe come back to you can have the football field.
Question. All right. All those in favor of approval, let it know by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion passes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, we have an update on building projects.
Madam Chairman, members of the board, we had a construction meeting at Watauga last week, and the work that's going on down there right now is a lot of demolition from the old portion of the building being taken out and removed from the site. The new section is, for all practical purposes, completed. I think we still lack one serving line in the cafeteria. And they did some painting over the holidays in the hallways where the paint had come off, so they've got that remedied. And the contractor tells me, providing the weather shows a little mercy on him, that once they get this material removed from the site, that he's ready to go ahead and put the pad in. He was hoping to do that in the month of January. But when you have weather in the teams, you can't pour concrete or do any of those things. But he's going to start forming those up, and he was going to take advantage of every warm day he could get. Central office building, by the way, going back to the top, I know Mr. White, you noticed or not, the family could drop the students off in the back of the building. It took a lot of pressure off the highway out there to get those students.
I was up there the other day, and it's
works great. Central office building built out here. We are about 90% complete. We lack several items. We had some issues with one of the subcontractors who became very ill. and he bought his company, folded, and the company had to supplement his contract. And that is the company that builds all the cabinetry and the window seals and all those things. We should be totally complete here within just the next few weeks. Once we get completed, we will set a date for an open house for the public to come in and tour the facility. By that time, it'll be old hat. We'd like to welcome everyone here this evening. This is the first time that we've got to use this facility, and very pleased with it. In the past, our boardroom was so small that we had to put part of the people in the overflow room. But tonight, we have practically all the chairs from the overflow room in this room. So this room will accommodate a much larger audience. I will tell you that the staff is extremely happy to be in this building. They weren't happy about 3 weeks ago when we were moving, but I think they've gotten over that. But we'll talk about that in more than a few minutes. The Springfield Middle School HVAC, we put in a new boiler at Springfield Middle School over the holidays. Thank goodness we did that. It's always been kind of cool over there, but we now have two much smaller looking boilers because of the technology and how those things have become more efficient and improved over the years. We feel pretty good about going through this winter and students and teachers and staff being comfortable. So that was a big thing. The other thing we did with facilities over the holiday is we had a sewage line that was stopped up, and it had been stopped up for a long time down in Greenbrier Middle School. We had a contractor go in, and when he got in there, he had to remove the old existing sewer line and install a new one that's given some relief to that end of the building where the gym is located. And we didn't know it was as bad as it was, but we were very fortunate to get that done when we were out of school. The last thing I will tell you is that Crestview Elementary School, the contractor did some work out there, punch list items. He is almost complete. He has a few door hardware issues he's got to fix up, and then there's some grading to the exterior of the building that has to be done in the spring and grass did, but we're pretty much complete over there at Crestview. So that concludes my report on the building projects, subject to your questions.
Any questions?
Report. Madam Chairman, members of the board, 45 years ago tonight, the school board met at 2121 Woodlawn Street. That's how long since that building served us as a central office. And it served for many, many years prior to that as a school. I think we got some good use out of that building, and we are certainly pleased on that 45th anniversary to begin anew here in this facility. But the big move to the central office was very challenging. I will want to thank Jimmy Finch. Any of your folks here, Jimmy?
No.
Just you. Well, you can stand up. Jimmy Finch and his maintenance crew really worked hard to get us moved over here. And it was a much larger challenge than we first anticipated. I really didn't know we had that much stuff in that old building, but we had a lot of stuff, and we still have some, Jimmy. We're not finished.
Right.
So we're going to have to move the rest of it. But they did it in a smooth and orderly manner, and no one was injured. I'd also like to thank the central office staff. They worked hard today. There's people using the private personal vehicles, piling stuff in pickup trucks and vans and cars, and moving it over to our new location here at 800 MS Couch Boulevard. As I told you earlier, the central office still lacks some things, such as the signage is not completed, the outdoor lighting is lacking, we have some plumbing that still has to be finished. Several people have asked, and this is the time of year that everyone wants to ask the question about, when do you call school off? When it snows, if it comes, you know, we have dusting snow, I think, on Saturday or Sunday morning. We will notify everyone in a timely manner, as early as we possibly can, as soon as we make a decision. We will not have school if it puts people's
lives in danger or safety in danger. We want to make sure that everyone is safe, and so we will be posting it on our website. We will be doing our call-outs to parents. We will be letting the local media know about it. So we'll try to inform you every way we know how to inform you, email, text, voice, any way we can have at our disposal. So we'll try to let you know as quickly as possible. When the weather gets down into single digits, it creates a huge challenge for our bus transportation department. A lot of buses won't turn over. These lanes just won't turn over when it gets down to 4 or 5 degrees above zero. So we want to make sure that it doesn't have to snow. If we get some of these polar vortexes they keep talking about, we may have to consider those for some of our inclement weather days. We have 9 days banked in our calendar to use if we need to use them. And so we're holding on to them because the weather forecast, El Nino is supposed to bring us some really challenging weather events this winter. We will not be in school next Monday. We'll be in observance of Martin Luther King Day. So that day is out of the calendar, and students will get a long weekend this weekend, students and staff. The last week of January is a very important week. It's the National School Board Week of Appreciation. And I have a proclamation here from Mayor Bradley's office. If I may, Madam Chairman, I'd like to read that. It says, whereas an excellent public education system is vital to the quality of life of our community and to the economic development of our state, and whereas school board members represent a tremendous resource as local decision makers, diligently working to meet the challenges of a dynamic world while ensuring that every child receives the services needed to for a quality education. And whereas the school board members support and appreciate the efforts of school students, educators, and administrators, which have led to Tennessee becoming